हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन बीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर सेमिस्टर फर्स्ट यू हैव टू लर्न टू पेपर्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। फर्स्ट पेपर इज द डिफरेंशियल कैलकुलस एंड सेकंड पेपर इज द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। नाउ आई विल टीच डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। माय नेम इज खाकरे आरे। आई विल टीच यू डिफरेंशियल कैलकुलस। In differential calculus, you have to learn differential calculus and vector calculus. In differential calculus, you have to learn differentiation, successive differentiation, partial derivative, and in vector calculus, you have to learn differential operators for this year, for this semester. Now in differential calculus, we start from the chapter first, differentiation. Differentiation. Now to learn differentiation, you know the limit. You learn the limit of a function in 11th and 12th standard. Again you know the function. So I will tell you what is function. Suppose x is one set, y is another set. Suppose these are some points A, B, C, D, E, F and G are the points of the set X, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 these are the points of the set Y. If each point of the set X associate to each point of the set Y, suppose A associate to 1, B associate to 2, C associate to 5, D associate to suppose 3, E associate to 7, F associate to 6, and G associate to suppose 4. Here every point of the set X associate with the every point of the set Y, then you say that there is some correspondence between X and Y, and suppose that correspondence is F, you do not F. Here, F is a function such that, or F is a correspondence such that every point of X associate with the every point of Y, and it can be denoted as F is defined from X to Y. Here, X is the domain of that function and Y is the codomain of that function, and here A, B, C, D, E, F, G are the points of the domain, and 1, 2, 3, 4 are the points of the codomain. Means here image of A, F of A is 1, image of the point A under F is 1, F of B is 2. Similarly, and so on, the image of function, image of the point G is 4. Or this can be written as A is F inverse 1. A is equal to F inverse 1. Means inverse image of 1 is A. So you remember here only, F is a function from X to Y, X is the domain and Y is the codomain. Now, you learn differentiation. You know the limit of a function, algebra of a limit of function. Again, you know, already you learn the derivative of a function and limit of continuous function. That is, if f of x is a function and you say that f is continuous at some point, x tends to c or any point, if limit of f of x as x tends to c is equal to f of c, means the value of function f of c is equal to the limit of f of x at x tends to c, if this condition is satisfied, then you say that f is continuous at point c or for point c. If f is not continuous, then value of f of c is not equal to the limit of f of x as x tends to c. Already you know this. Now, what is derivative to a derivable function definition? Now we see the definition of a derivative of a function means a function is said to be derivable at point C if limit of f of c plus h minus f of c upon h as h tends to 0 exists and the limit is called the derivative of the function at C and is denoted by f dash c. Here c is a point of domain. That is, f dash c is equal to limit of f of c plus h minus f of c upon h as h tends to 0. Or in general, for any x belongs to R, you have instead of f dash c, c is a particular point, f dash x here is equal to limit as h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x upon h for all x belongs to a domain D. Or here domain is set of a real number R. Or you say that the function is a finitely derivable if limit of f of c plus h minus f of c upon h as h tends to 0 is finite. Then you say that the derivative is, or we say that the function is finitely derivable. Now using this first principle of derivative, we see some examples. Example number 1. Find the derivative of f of x is equal to, suppose, x square, x, suppose x belongs to R. Solution. Now here, domain of a function is set of real numbers. Entire domain is set of real numbers. Here, domain of range also. Domain of a function or range of a function is R. By definition of derivative, we have, so what is definition of derivative of a function? F of x, f dash x is equal to limit as h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. Now here we have to find the derivative of the f of x is equal to x square. Using the formula of derivative, it is easy. X square. Now you know the derivative of x raised to n. X raised to n means, suppose f of x is equal to x raised to n, then f dash x is equal to n into x raised to n minus 1. Here n means 2. Therefore, f dash x is equal to n means 2. 2 into x raised to 2 minus 1 means your answer is 2 minus 1 means 1. 2x. It is easy using your formula. Derivative of this f of x is equal to x square is 2x. But this is using formula. What you have to, using the first principle of derivative, you have to find the derivative of f of x is equal to x square. Here, f of x is equal to x square. Therefore, f dash x is equal to limit as x tends to 0, f of x is equal to x square. Therefore, f of x plus s means, f of x plus means x plus s square minus f of x means x square upon s. And you expand x plus s square by x plus y square. So, is equal to limit as s tends to 0, x square plus 2x into s plus s square, a plus b whole square, minus x square upon h. Plus x square minus x square cancel. Then what is remaining? Is equal to limit as s tends to 0, 2, here you 2xh plus h square, you take h again common, 2x plus h into h upon h, again this h is cancel, you don't cancel here directly. So again what is remaining? Limit as h tends to 0, 2x plus h. Again, I'll draw up limit. Limit of 2x as h tends to 0. 2x is free from h, therefore its limit is 2x. And limit as h tends to 0 of h means 0 plus 0 is equal to 2x. Therefore, f dash x is equal to 2x. Or derivative of x square is 2x. Therefore, d dx of x square is equal to 2x. So, in this way, by using first principle of derivative, you find the derivative of a given function. Again, we see one more example. Example second. Find the derivative of the function f of x is equal to root x, under root x. Solution. Now here, the range of the function f is from 0 to infinity. So you remember, range of the function is from 0 to infinity. Again, by definition of derivative, we have f dash x is equal to limit as h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. Now, what is f of x here? Here, f of x is equal to root x. Therefore, f dash x means derivative of root x is equal to limit as h tends to 0, f of x is equal to root x. Therefore, f of x plus h means root x plus h minus f of x means root x upon h. Now, how to find the limit of this? You rationalize the conjugate of root x plus h minus root x. Here, the conjugate of root x plus h minus root x is the root of x plus h plus root x. Rationalize means you divide and multiply of this conjugate. Therefore, f dash x is equal to root x plus h minus root x upon h. You divide and multiply, its conjugate means root x plus h plus root x upon root x plus h plus root x. Now here root x plus h minus root x, and here root x plus h plus root x. You know the formula, that is a square minus b square is equal to a minus b into a plus b, a square minus b square. Therefore here root of x plus h square minus root x square. For root of x plus h square means root cancel. So only you have x plus h minus b square means root x square. Square root of x square as only minus x upon h into root x plus h plus root x. But limit of this f dash x is equal to limit of this as h tends to 0. Again, is equal to limit of this as h tends to 0. Here x cancel. Next step, again h cancel. Therefore, is equal to limit as h tends to 0. Next step, not this step, next step h is cancelled. So after that step you get 1 upon root of x plus h plus root x. Again algebra of limit means limit of numerator upon limit of denominator. Limit. Here 1 is constant, so is equal to 1 upon s tends to 0. Root of x plus 0 plus root x. Root x plus root x means 2 root x. Therefore, is equal to 1 upon 2 root x. So, this is the derivative of root x. Thus, the derivative of root x by using first principle 1 upon 2 root x. Or from directly formula, you can also have the derivative of root x is 1 upon 2 root x. Now this can be written as 1 upon 2 into x raised to minus 1 by 2 also. Now these are some we have seen two examples of function finding the derivative. Now we see one important theorem on derivative. Now we see the theorem, that is, now next we see, next lecture we see the derivability implies the continuity, but continuity does not imply the derivability. So today we stop here. Thank you.